Dear students, let's discuss the concept of maxima and minima of a function. Always remember that for a given function, y is equals to f of x, if for a particular value of x, value of y is either maxima or minimum, if we can also write it down, for a value of x, if y is either maximum or minimum relative to the neighborhood values, then these points are called points of maxima or minima of the function. Graphically, these points can be very easily seen. Like, if we draw the graph of a function in x and y, say, this is the curve of a function y is equals to f of x. You can see, at a particular value of x, say it is x1, the value of y is maximum, say it is y1, is maximum compared to neighborhood values. In the similar manner, at a point x2, if we see, at this point value of y, y2 is minimum compared to neighborhood values. Similarly, there is one more point, say at x equals to x3, the value of y is getting maximum compared to neighborhood values. Now, in this situation, there is a common thing between these three points. That is, if we just draw the tangent at these three points, you can see that the tangents are horizontal. If tangents are horizontal, these are making an angle 0 degree with the x-axis. So, at all these points, we can state the slope of the graph is equal to 0. So, we can say at points of maxima or minima, we can simply state slope of graph is equals to 0, or we can write dy by dx is equals to 0. So, for any point of the curve, if curve is having either a maximum value or a minimum value, we can simply state at those points, differentiation of curve or differentiation of function with respect to its free variable or independent variable will be equals to 0. So, always remember this. Let's discuss the process of finding the points of maxima or minima. As we have studied, maxima and minima are the points where the slope of the function will become 0. Now, for this, we can simply state, for a given function y is equals to f of x, to find its maximum or minimum values, we put dy by dx, or which is f prime x, is equal to 0. On solving this expression, we get some values of x, value or values of x. Now, these are the values of x for which dy by dx is becoming 0, or we can simply state slope of function is becoming 0. That means these are the points which are the points of maxima or minima. Now, to check whether at a value of x, y is maximum or minimum, we use another method we call second derivative check. Using the second derivative check, we can easily determine that at a particular value of x, where a slope is becoming 0, whether it is maxima or minima, we can determine. Let's see what it is. Second derivative check. This is a rule used to check whether at a value of x, y is maximum or minimum. In a given function, y is equals to f of x. For this function, the optimum values of y or the values of x for which y is going to become maximum can be easily obtained by differentiating it and equating it to 0, which we already studied. We can simply state for y to be maximum or minimum, dy by dx or f prime x should be equal to 0. Say, solving this equation, we get x is equals to x1, x2, x3 and so on. Some values of x we are getting where the value of dy by dx or a slope or function is becoming 0. Now to analyze whether at these values y is going to become maximum or minimum, we just find it out its second derivative. Now we find second derivative as d square y by dx square, or it is f double prime x. Now if we put the values of x, x1, x2, x3 in this function, then depending on the final sign of this value, we determine whether y is maximum or minimum. Here you can simply state according to second derivative check, if f double prime x comes out to be a positive quantity, this means at this particular value of x, y is minimum. And if f double prime x on substituting a particular value of x is it comes out to be a negative quantity, then it means at this point y is maximum. This is the way our second derivative check works. Right now we are not going into the derivation how it is coming, but this is the direct rule which is going to be used in several cases of physics. You need to keep it in mind that second derivative, if it comes out to be positive at a particular value of x, either of x1, x2 or x3, if it comes out to be positive, then at that value of x, y will be minimum. And if it comes out to be negative, then at those values of x, y will be maximum. To analyze the same, we take up an example. Say we are given with a function y is equals to 3x square plus 5x minus 4. And we are required to find maximum or minimum values of y. For this, what we'll do? In the beginning, we find out the value of dy by dx, which will give us the slope of this function. It is 6x plus 5. And directly we equate it to 0. Here you can simply see the value of x we are getting is minus 5 by 6. There is only one value of x we are getting where dy by dx is becoming 0. That means it is either maximum or minimum. We cannot have both the values of y. We can have either maximum or minimum. Now just to check whether at this value of x, value of y is maximum or minimum, we find out the second derivative, that is d square y by dx square. It will come out to be 6. You can see this is a positive value. If d square y by dx square, according to second derivative, if it comes out to be positive, this implies at any value of x, as we are having a single value, we don't need to substitute the value of x. We can simply state the value of y is minimum. And the minimum value of y we can simply calculate just by substituting the value of x minus 5 by 6 in this expression, which will be 3 into minus 5 by 6 whole square plus 5 into minus 5 by 6 minus 4. You can easily calculate it. This will be the answer, which is the minimum value of y which we can get. And here we can say there is only one value of x at which y is becoming minimum. We say here no absolute value exists for which y is maximum. It may extend to infinity. That means there is no particular or absolute value exist. You can also say of x for which y is becoming maximum. As we are getting just a single optimum value or single value of x for which y is becoming optimum.